move towards evening in the world of women gymnasts. But Kathy has continued to chase the Olympic dream and came to Jacksonville with high hopes. A poor performance on the uneven bars last night in the compulsories almost ended her dream. But Kathy is a fighter. She came back to score well on the balance beam and the vault, and then ended the evening with this brilliant performance in the floor exercise. She scored a 9.9, and that put her back in contention for a spot on the women's Olympic team. At the conclusion of the compulsories, the leader was Mary Lou Retton, who has seen 16 candles on her birthday cake and will be very tough to beat. Olympic Trials, Women's Gymnastics, live from Jacksonville, Florida. This ABC Sports exclusive is being brought to you by AT&T Communications. Just think of us in ways you never thought of. By Nissan, builders of high-mileage, high-quality cars and trucks for 50 years. Available at your Datsun dealer. And by Pizza Hut, home of the Pan Pizza. Good evening, everybody. Live from Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Jacksonville, Florida, hard by the Gator Bowl, women's gymnastics trying for the Olympic team for 1984. Here are the current standings after two rotations in the optionals. Mary Lou Retton leads and Julianne McNamara is second. They have been 1 and 2 almost all year. Michelle Ducer now has moved into third place with Pam Billick fourth. Lucy Wehner is fifth, and as you see, Maria Roethlisberger in this last rotation has just moved up into sixth place. Tracee Talavera and on. Now, eight is the key here. Eight will make what they call the Olympic squad. And here's how that is determined. Seven gymnasts will make up the team. There will be one alternate. The top four here in Jacksonville tonight definitely will go on to Los Angeles. The last four spots of those eight we talked about will be determined after a competition against Canada in July. There will be, in its essence, two alternates, one alternate and an alternate for the alternate. So eight is the key word to worry about here tonight. We have four rotations here tonight. Three have just been completed. We'll be ready for the last rotation in just a moment or two. Jack Whitaker here, along with Kathy Rigby, one of our finest women gymnasts ever produced in the United States. And Kathy, why would the women's team wait until July and another competition to pick those last four?
Well, basically, I think our selection committee wants to send the best team possible, and some of our gymnasts have been in and out of optimum form over the last few months because of injury or illness, and we just want to send the best team possible, and by selecting them at the last minute, this is what's going to happen. Perfect example, Diane Durham. She scratched the meet. She was vaulting in her third rotation. On the first vault, she missed. She had a she was doing a full twisting Sukuhara. She can see her ankles are injured. There is a rule concerning this. She will be able to petition in. She had to finish in the top eight in the USA Championship. She did that. They will use her score from the championships, double it, and it must be higher than the overall eighth place finisher here to give her a spot on the team. And you can see it right here. There's ABC's super slow motion here. You can see exactly what has happened. She was completing her full twisting Sukuhara, didn't get quite around on the twist, a little low with the shoulders, and you'll see that she jams her ankles very hard. She's already had many leg problems in the past, and just too far over, couldn't get up and cannot complete the competition. So she has officially scratched, but will petition.
So they will take, if they take her petition, double her championship score, and if that puts her in the first eight here, then she can go on.
Exactly.
She had a 9-1 on that vault, but what thing is, however, that she has to get that ankle well too, doesn't she?
Absolutely.
Along with everything else.
And this is one of the reasons that the selection committee is going to wait till the last minute, because they don't know whether Diane can get better, or any of the girls. If they get injured in training camp, they just want to wait and make sure they're in the best possible form.
Second item, with the defection of the Soviet Union and the Eastern Bloc countries, It affects gymnastics quite a bit because they were very strong in it. How does it affect these trials in Jacksonville, Kathy?
Well, it would be an untruth to say that it isn't very disappointing and it won't hurt gymnastics. The top countries are always very spectacular, but we have a spectacular team this year. And I'm talking about Mary Lou Retton, Julianne McNamara, if they make the team, which should be no problem. Another thing that's important to think about here is that this is going to be not only a chance for them to win medals in individual apparatus competition, but also in the team competition and the all-around competition, which they're really looking forward to. It has been very intense in this competition so far, more intense than I've ever seen in a trials. Mm-hmm. They know that this is a chance for them to win gold medals.
All right, they're in their warm-up now. There's no competition going on behind us. We'll be ready in about 2.5 minutes. Ironically, today, of course, is the day when everybody must notify the Olympic Committee in Los Angeles whether they're going to participate or not. We still have a few hours because the deadline, we're told, is the westernmost part of the world when Saturday becomes Sunday. I guess that's in the middle of the Pacific Ocean by the international dateline. But even so, we're going to have a record number of nations there. 132 at least will be showing up in Los Angeles. We now have the current standings after the first three rotations here in the optionals tonight, and Mary Lou Retton and Julie McNamara still running 1 and 2. Michelle Dusser has held in at in the third place. And here is where the real fight is coming. Kathy Johnson, who has been doing a tremendous job in coming back after that bad show last night on the uneven bars. Tracee Talavera, that's where it is, all with the fight. There is Mary Lou Retton, the leader, and we'll be back here in Jacksonville in just a moment. We have a microphone on him tonight. There is quite a tremendous relationship between the coach and the performer, and Bela is very close to all his charges. That would be Mary Lou Retton, Julianne McNamara, and Diane Durham, who came back to Bela this week. Let's see if we can hear him.
Good. Easy. Yes. Easy. Yes. Go. Good. And press it. Go. Good. And go, Kelly. Nicely. Straight. Press on your toes. And press on your toes. Good. And nicely.
And there's another one of Baylor's pupils, Mary Lou Retton, who is leading here. And she'll be first up in this rotation.
She has been absolutely dynamic in the entire competition, very secure on all her apparatus. I think that's also a credit to Bela for preparing his gymnast so well mentally. So far, she's moved extremely well. Look at that back tuck from a handstand. At this point, she should be extremely confident. Scissor leap, two in a row, very difficult. Mary Lou has brute strength in the legs. She barely moves her upper torso at all to make any movement. Here's her front flip, right on. Very difficult line move. She cannot see where she's landing. And the music in the background, obviously, is not for the balance beam. Slight break there. Approximately 2/10 of a point. In her arms and her suppleness in her upper body.
She's such an explosive performer, though, isn't she?
Absolutely. I guess that's the best word for Mary Lou, and she is going to be very dynamic at the Olympics. Great difficulty getting ready for her dismount now. Round up, double back, right on.
Got that one.
You can see why she's been wowing audiences all over the world.
Good job.
Good job. Good job, little girl. Good job, little girl.
Yes. Good job. A happy coach also. Bela Karoly and Mary Lou Retton, who I guess just about wraps up first place. But she will definitely be going to Los Angeles. Let's take another look in super slow motion of her dismount, Kathy.
You can see the extreme power this woman has in her legs. She lifts it straight up in the air. Here's the round off. To land both feet on the beam is especially difficult because it's so narrow, only 4 inches wide. Right up to the top, she completes her second flip almost above the balance beam, lands at a complete stop, which is so important.
There she is. That's the smile you're going to see a lot this summer. Let's go to the uneven bars now. So really a comeback story here. Kathy Johnson. There she is, number six. She's trying to overcome a 7.65 mark in the compulsories last night on the uneven bars, and since then she's almost been perfect.
Kathy is a real fighter, and she's been stronger in this competition after beginning so poorly. You have to give her a great deal of credit. This Olympics means more to her than any other competition. She was in the 1980 Olympic trials, made the team. In fact, she placed first for the Americans going into the trials.
Mary Lou Retton has gotten a 9.6 for her beam. And as we were saying earlier, she is definitely on her way to Los Angeles.
Absolutely. This is the most critical event for Kathy. She's completed the balance beam, which is another critical event. There's Mary Lou's score, 9.6.
Kathy Johnson, 24 years old. Most gymnasts, 24 years old, are home.
They're home and out of the picture. But not Kathy. She says she has a motor driving her on that she would like to smash sometimes, but I'm sure not tonight. This has been a very tense competition for Kathy. Half twist to the high bar. This is the event that she needs to hold on to. Reverse hex, kick to the high bar, right into a handstand. There's her delta, drop to the low bar. She's moving extremely well right now. Good form. Tawan, giant swing. And a double twisting flyaway. Great routine. Kathy has come back.
And the crowd is with her.
What a gallant fight.
She has been over 9.5 on every event since last night. Here's a dismount.
And holding her breath right to the end here on this double flyaway. She needs to lift her hips way above. Completes a double twist. No form breaks. Difficult dismount to do without form breaks. Good, good exercise.
Mary Lou Retton congratulating her. She's currently seventh. If she can hang in there, she'll live to compete another day. 9.7, and that might do it for her. Now, Tracee Talavera is fighting for the same berth that Kathy Johnson is. Here she is getting ready for the vault, her first vault.
Tracee has kind of dropped out of gymnastics quite a few months ago. Was not really happy with the sport, changed coaches. She's back. This year, she has done extremely well, especially the last couple of months. She does a very unusual vault. She does a round off to the board, as you'll see. No one else in the meet does. Round off, back with a full, very nice vault. Could not be executed better. Good landing.
She's a tall lady, too, which means she has to turn a little quicker, don't you?
Poor Jimmy. Yes, she does. A lot more body to get around.
Tracee Talavera's first vault. They'll take the best of the two. And she in tight competition with Marie Roethlisberger and Kathy Johnson in those last two spots.
And Jack, all three of those gymnasts have done extremely well tonight. They've all been pushing very hard. And the routine show.
9.65 for Tracee on her first vault.
And natural, she's going to try to better it. With her second vault, they will count the best of the two. And she waits for the judge to give her the green flag, which she just did. Timing, the run, everything is important, especially to explode on this first part.
That's great. She might have gotten a ticket to Los Angeles.
That's
on that.
That's right.
Huh?
Well, she's fighting.
Woo. That's what you call sticking, huh?
That's right.
You land like that.
Stick it. That's what we say.
Now this is Julianne McNamara in second place at the moment.
This is a good event for Julianne.
This is her strength.
Her best. Shoot to a handstand. She flows on this event so well. Reverse heck there.
Tracee has a 9.85 on the ball.
Right.
Increases her chance as well.
So far, Julianne has probably shown the best routine we've seen thus far in the competition. No effort in this routine, it seems.
Oh.
Very nice.
Big smile.
What a relief.
A hug from Bella.
You finished nicely. Good competition of you. Good job. Good job, buddies. All right. That was a nice one. Good job.
The coach is happy.
Good competition. Yeah, was
nothing feels
competition
better than
for a long time
having your coach happy, believe
good
me.
Job.
Well, it is, I said earlier, a close relationship, isn't it?
They're like fathers to you or mothers. You live with them in the gym every moment.
Here comes Julie's score, 9.85.
Well deserved.
So really, what we're talking about are still those seventh and eighth position. Yumi Mordva in ninth position right now. Concentrating on those people who are fighting for the last spot here.
And this is a good event for Yumi also. She's a very strong competitor, very much like Mary Lou. Taller than most of the gymnasts. Handstand there. Another giant. Belchev. She's a little bit slow there on that swing. They're a handstand. Release right over the low bar. Tip to the high bar now. Moving very well so far. Slight break in the legs there. Komenich dismount. Another good routine.
Yumi Mordva from Seattle, Washington, lives now in Vashon Island, Washington. She's 18. Currently in ninth position, fighting desperately to be eight.
And a big relief. But let's take a look at the super slow motion. On just the hands, you can see that the grip is so important. Those hands are so strong. I don't think most people realize you have muscles in those fingers as well, just to grasp that bar. And with the pressure coming around on the apparatus, it's important to have that kind of strength. So every part of the body is used with a great deal of strength on this apparatus. You can see the grips to keep the hands from tearing and keep the moisture out. You can see that one of the requirements is release movement.
There she is, Yumi Mordva, waiting for her score. As we all are here.
Waiting for your score and waiting to go on your apparatus are the two worst moments. The anticipation.
There's Mary Lou Retton, the leader.
And she is very relaxed.
All finished her competition here. Secure in the knowledge that she has indeed made this Olympic team. When that music stops for the floor exercise, it really gets quiet, doesn't
it? It does. And if you're on the balance beam at that point, it probably affects you more than when it's very loud.
Well, there must be some discussion with the judges on Yumi Mordred's score, and while we're waiting to that, we're going to see Michelle Goodman, number 17, from Reading, PA, getting ready for the balance beam.
Michelle,
this is an elegant-looking piece of equipment that is a marvelous piece of torture, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oof.
It certainly is.
Four inches
wide and seems about 2 inches when you're up there in competition of this sort. Michelle has been up and down as far as this year is concerned, as far as her ranking. She's a top flight gymnast, has been on the national team a couple of years.
Yumi Mordred's score was 9.50 on the uneven bar.
One of the things that the judges are looking for now more than ever is the gymnast not to be too cautious. As you can see, it causes them to bobble a little bit more when they're too controlled. You want to be controlled to the point that you know what you're doing at all times and your body is tight, but not to the point where it inhibits you. There's a jump stag. showing flexibility, also a requirement on the balance beam. And a full turn. Every element should be completed to its fullest. For example, that scissor split should have been a little bit more split. Complete split in the air, getting ready for a backhand spring straddle down, right to her toes. Fluidity, suppleness, all requirements here. You can see the concentration on her faces. And her dismount. Round off, double twist, good landing. Fairly good exercise.
Michelle Goodwin. And that concludes the competition on the balance beam. We'll await for her. Let's take a look at our overhead camera on the balance beam. You'll get a little... In fact, the beam in this shot looks wider than it really is, though, doesn't it?
I don't know about that. It looks pretty skinny to me. But you can see that the shoulders, the hips, and the legs have to be right in line. And when you're concentrating up there, this is actually the perspective of the gymnast looking down. And you try to line yourself up. As you can see, her hips and shoulders stay right over that balance beam.
You're supposed to make the judges believe you're doing it on a flat floor.
That's right. Well, if you believe that, no, that's what it should look like.
Hmm?
Exactly. Very interesting perspective.
We're getting ready now for Michelle Goodwin's marks. And on the floor exercise, the last competitor there, JoJo Sims from Washington, D.C., training in Fort Worth, Texas.
And JoJo
with Scott Kraus.
Right. JoJo really doesn't have a chance to make the team here, but this is a great opportunity for some of these young gymnasts who will continue over the next 4 years. This is the kind of experience they need, this kind of pressure, because this is what they'll be facing in the future with international competition.
Now, this program can be anywhere from 70 to 120 seconds.
Right. That is correct. And most of the gymnasts have three superior tumbling runs. And they dance. And it all has to flow together to the music. This is JoJo's first tumbling run. And the great difficulty they're now doing. There's a double back, a little bit low. Almost stepped out there. Of some of the other top great gymnasts here, but she has time to work on that. And it really is an honor just to make the Olympic trials in this country. In her last tumbling run, another double twist. Okay, nice exercise, JoJo.
JoJo Sims. Michelle Goodwin's score on the balance beam was 9.35 as JoJo Sims get a hug from teammates over there, and we'll return to Jacksonville and the Women's Olympic Trials in Gymnastics in just a moment. I'm at Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Jacksonville, Florida, where the women's optionals have just been concluded in the Olympic Trials, and we're waiting for the computer now to digest all the material and tell us who has made the team. But unofficially, and this will be quite a story if it holds up, Kathy Johnson has finished in eighth place. Mary Lou Retton there, definitely at number one, along with Julianne McNamara, number two. And we'll wait now until we get the official word. But if Kathy Johnson does, that is coming back from adversity in a sport where it's, you know, that's like a golfer taking a 10 on the first hole in the U.S. Open and then winning the championship. Taking a 7.65 in that first apparatus yesterday.
This has to be the best moment in Kathy's life. She did start out so badly, and there was the odds of her making the Olympic team, I think, were a million to one. She's a fighter. She's been through many competitions. This would have been a real heartbreak for her if she had not made the team. I think that the crowd is with her. Her teammates are with her, and I think the world of gymnastics couldn't be happier for her.
That's Julianne McNamara on the right of your screen and Mary Lou Retton, 1 and 2 here in these Olympic trials. And big smiles, a smile of Mary Lou Retton will light up the world this summer. There's their coach, Bela Karoli, who looks like Mike Ditka of the Chicago Bears. I think he was a basketball player. Let's hear what he's saying.
Well.
Diane looks good.
Well, unfortunately, she did an accident. Feel alive.
Now it's muscatel time.
Well, Diane Durham is really the tragedy here because Kathy has gotten into eighth place. Diane Durham, it doesn't look like we'll make it. And that's a heartbreak in any year, but an Olympic year, certainly.
And she's done so well this past year. She has been plagued with quite a few injuries. As you remember, at the American Cup, she was injured. It's difficult to come back so soon from as many injuries as she has had. I think the ruling leaves less room for discrepancy and less room for other people who have made the team to get upset. So it is a good rule.
There's Mary Lou Retton. You know, she is so different in style from Julianne, isn't she? I mean, they're both coached by the same person, but they're so different. Here is the team, and it is now official. Mary Lou Retton, Julianne McNamara, Michelle Dusserre, and Pam Bilek will all go to Los Angeles, definitely. Now, the last four will have to compete against Canada in Los Angeles in July to qualify for the final two spots. And there they are, Tracee Talavera, Marie Roethlisberger, and Kathy Johnson, and Lucy Wainer. Now, Marie Roethlisberger is also quite a story. Deaf in one ear, partially deaf in the other. And you need that inner balance in this sport, don't you?
It's very interesting how she does have such tremendous balance with that kind of a handicap, but it has never hurt her in any of her competition, obviously. Another great, interesting thing about Marie is that I competed with her father in 1968, Fred Roethlisberger, so he must be very proud.
Well, there's a very happy story here in Kathy Johnson, a very sad story here in Diane Durham, and for those of you who joined us late, this is the Diane Durham story as it happened tonight. She was well situated with a strong performance tonight to make the final eight, and then tragedy struck on the vault. The left ankle. You can see the tears, not of pain as much as they are of sadness and heartbreak. Here is how it happened.
She was doing a Sukahara with a full twist. Everything was fine in the beginning of her vault. It looks like her repulsion from the horse was all right. Her twist was a little bit slow. You'll see that she finishes it fairly low. Both ankles were really pushed on right there.
Marie Roethlisberger, Tracee Talavera,
Lucy
Wainer,
Pam Bilek, Michelle Dusserre, and
Julianne McNamara.
As well as the percentage of scores carried into this meet. We have a memento being presented to each member of the 1984 Olympic squad by Debbie Doyle, the chairman of the Jacksonville Sports and Entertainment Commission.
All right, there's the women's team. We've done that business that we came down to Jacksonville for. Tomorrow afternoon, the men will have their finals and the options. And to talk about that, we have Gordon Maddox here with us and Bart Connor. Gordon? Trouble hearing it.
75.5 from Scats in Huntington Beach, California.
We're having a microphone problem there, ladies and gentlemen. So let's go back to the ladies as they take their curtain calls. There is Maria Ratzelberger, and you can see the hearing aid there in that right ear.
Exactly, and a proud mom and pop out there.
With 75.516.
And here is Tracee Talavera.
It's interesting, Jack, because a lot of these ladies have really fought their way to the top after some injuries, some personal problems, and they're up there. Kathy Johnson, Tracee Talavera especially, I'm talking about. A great comeback.
0.740 from Scats in Huntington Beach, California,
Lucy Werner.
Who just last year was ranked fairly low on the American scene and has come all the way up to the Olympic team.
In fourth place, scoring 75.
Marina High School in Huntington Beach is going to be very proud of her tonight.
That's
California,
right.
Pam Bilak.
And here's Pam Bilak. Also from Huntington Beach, Pacifica High School.
Another interesting fact is that there are two gymnastic teams here, Bella Caroli's team, and the Southern California Afro team. And, of course, Tracee Talavera, who also worked under the Scats at one time, so it's interesting.
In second place, scoring 76.796, from Caroli Gymnastics in Houston, Texas, Julianne McNamara.
Julianne, who had a rose named after her by the then Queen Julianne of the Netherlands. And now the smile runs like Carl Lewis and smiles like Olga Corbett.
0.164.
Mary Lou Retton.
Gymnastics in Houston.
Could win a lot of gold at the Olympics.
We'll have more of the United States Olympic Trials Women Gymnastics after this word from our local station. Back live from Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Jacksonville, Florida, where the women's gymnastic team for 1984 Olympics have been concluded. They have been chosen. There they are. The last four places to be determined in what order a little later on, but the first four there from right to left has already been ticketed for Los Angeles. One of those is Michelle Ducere of Garden Grove, California, Pacifica High School, coached by Don Peters. She's strongest in the floor exercise, so let's take a look at how she did here earlier this evening.
Well, she began with a full in back out, and this gymnast is spectacular. She's worked very hard to get here. There's her double back, second tumbling run, full turn, dynamic. Her dance is good, choreographed by Mary Wright. Started gymnastics at 4 years old. Here's her second tumbling run. Triple twist. Exercise so far. Great flexibility. Every part of this routine is right on. Now the music that you're hearing now is not her floor exercise music. It's being overpowered by the band. But she was right on the music and right on this floor exercise routine.
15-year-old Michelle Ducere from Garden Grove, California, in her floor exercise tonight. She finished third. She's on her way to Los Angeles for the Olympics. We're back here live at the Coliseum, and now let's go to Gordon.
Yeah, we're here.
And Bart Connor.
Okay, Bart, we have a luxury we haven't had before, but here you are, one of the leaders in the men's competition. I notice none of the other guys are here. What do you suppose they're doing?
I imagine they're probably back watching it on TV right now, as a matter of fact. But I wanted to come over because this is a fantastic group of girls. And, you know, it's always a little more intense in Olympic trial competition. And I thought they did a great job. I wanted to be here to see it.
What's it been like for you? Now, you're a petitioning athlete, and the scores are a little bit different for you than they are the other athlete.
Yeah, the way it worked for the men's qualification procedure is that from the USA Championships, you know, you count 30% of your score from that event plus 70% of your score from this event. Well, in my case, since I petitioned through the USA Championships, I have to count 100% of what I do here. So far, that's working to my advantage. I'm in pretty good shape.
Were you nervous last night and this morning?
Yeah, it's kind of crazy because, like I said before, there is no meet like the Olympic trials. It seems like it's four or five times more intense than any other competition I've ever been in. And I've been doing this a long time, Gordon, and still, it's pretty intense.
Hey, congratulations. Good luck tomorrow.
Thanks very much.
We'll be back after this.
All the memories in this historic stamp collection at the post office.
Here's to good friends.
Terrific reunion.
Yeah. The last time we were here, we made history.
It's kind of special.
I stole that ball. I made the pass.
I made the shot.
Make that shot again, we'll buy you a low and drop.
The beer will pour.
Hey, what can I tell you? We still got it.
Never lost it.
Let it be low and brown. I tumble for you. I tumble for you.
The United States Olympic trials continue as America's finest compete for a chance to make the men's gymnastics squad. Plus, playoff hopefuls clash in the USFL. The Generals, led by the supercharged Herschel Walker, tackle Tampa Bay. Or division leaders square off as phenomenal Jim Kelly and the explosive Gamblers take on the Denver Gold. Also, Arizona at Birmingham. Turn on the action tomorrow with ABC Sports.
Back at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Jacksonville, Florida, we remind you once again that tonight is the deadline for countries to notify the Olympic Committee about whether or not they'll participate in Los Angeles, and no matter how many are in the boycott, we're going to have a record 132 nations there. This young lady, unfortunately, will be not there, and you can see the sadness there in those big brown eyes. Diane Durham, that is why the ankle hurt here in her first vault tonight, and she was in fairly good position there to secure a position on the team, and now it has all gone away. One girl who will be there, however, comeback of great sorts here in Jacksonville this weekend is Kathy Johnson, Gordon Mack.
Thanks, Jack. Kathy, first of all, congratulations on an enormous performance tonight. How do you feel about this qualification procedure?
It's very difficult. It always has been. This is, I believe, my seventh trials, and I've always sworn it'd be the death of me, each of these trials. But, you know, I almost gave it away in a split second. And it was the hardest thing I've ever done in my life to try and get it all back together and pull it through, but it was also the most rewarding thing I've ever done.
Well, you must have felt some really special things tonight as you went up for each performance, knowing that it was do or die.
It definitely was do or die, and each time I was thinking that it couldn't just be a hit. It had to be the hit of my life at that time.
And you think the selection process is fair after all is said and done?
I do. I think they should select eight and train them as if every single one would compete in the Olympic Games. And whoever the top six is at the time, they go on the floor. We've got a great group, a bunch of hard workers, and I think we got a super team.
Well, Kathy, tell me this. How do you feel about the Soviet boycott in all the Eastern European countries?
My initial thought was I was very disappointed. But the more I think about it, it's still the Olympics, and nobody's going to put a damper on the Olympics, because when it comes right down to it, gymnastics is an art and a sport. And I don't think politics should hurt it, so in my heart, it hasn't hurt it.
Well, now you've got your work cut out for you. You've got to train again for new trials.
That's right. But these are going to be easier because I can feel the Olympics right there.
Hey, good luck to you.
Johnson, who is 24 years old, a true veteran, and really right in the middle of this fight to make the team. We'll be back here to Jacksonville in just a moment.
Don Peters, and this is the first smile I've seen out of you.
Yeah, this is my first smile. No, this was a tough meet. It was so close, and these trials, if they didn't have trials, I think the coaches would all live a little longer. This was tough, but the kids did great. This team is going to be really, really good.
Can you run down the team and briefly tell me what you think about each one and how they're going to do at the Olympics?
Okay. Mary Lou Retton, I think, has a great chance to win the all-around in the Olympic Games. I think this kid's going to be she's going to be the surprise star of the 1984 Games, and she's just absolutely phenomenal. She's super. Julianne McNamara looked at her best form. I've never seen her look better. She was super. Michelle Desserre just did a great meet and finished in third and was beautiful. Pam Bilek was great. Lucy Wiener, Tracee Talavera moved up and came into sixth, and she did a great job tonight. And Marie Roethlisberger, who went into the competition with her elbow swollen, and I wasn't even sure she was going to be able to finish, came through real strong. And, of course, Kathy made the comeback of all comebacks to make the squad. So it was an exciting, exciting event.
Where do you go from here, training camp?
All right, we go home for a little while, and the kids will train at home with their individual coaches. And then we'll assemble the group the 1st of July, and we'll be training in Southern California. We'll have 3 weeks of training there. We have a practice meet with the Canadians on July 14th and 15th, and then we'll move into the village and go for the games.
Well, all of America wishes you and all the team the best luck in the world.
Well, this is the best team we've ever had, so I think it's going to be great.
Okay, back to you, Jack.
Thank you very much, Kathy. And that's Don Peters, who is the women's Olympic coach. And he is very happy because, in truth, this is the deepest team we've ever sent to an Olympics. Well, we turn here to Jacksonville to show you some action from earlier in the evening that you haven't seen of members of our brand-new Women's Olympic Gymnastic team. ...who has made this team, the young lady who has had a hearing defect from birth, deaf in one ear and partially deaf in the other. You see the hearing aid. Here was her performance tonight.
She mounted with a half-turn kip catch. This lady is so light. She moves effortlessly, stalter to a handstand, change grip, and she'll go right into a reverse hecht here. A little break slightly there, but nothing that really mattered in this competition. Live double leg shoot through. She moves very much like Julianne. No weight to take around there, and a double flyaway.
Maria Roethlisberger, 18 years of age, and she is going to go to Los Angeles to try and make that sixth, seventh, or eighth spot on the team. Back here live, where there's still people, as you see in the stands here, very happy and excited after this tremendous performance the last 2 days, and waiting patiently for tomorrow to see the men, which is a very close competition also. Now let's take a look at Pam Bilek, who also made this team. Here's our floor exercise from earlier tonight.
And she mounted with a full in back out, meaning she did a double back with a twist on the first flip. An exercise that takes a great deal of endurance. Critical move, and she was right on there. And you can see with a smile on her face, she was pretty happy about that tumbling run. As you can see, gymnasts take quite a bit of beating on their ankles. Both ankles are wrecked, as in the case of Diane Durham. And her second tumbling run will be a front through to a double twist here. Showing different combinations, something the judges look for. Very clean when she did that. And here's a change of pace in a routine, change in music style. Even when they're dancing around, every part of their body is tight and stretched. And here's her double twist. That's what makes the routine take a lot of endurance, and a double twist at the end there.
That's Pam Bilek. And there's Julianne McNamara live, still smiling.
And the weight of the world off her shoulders.
We'll give you that team again in case you joined us late. There are eight. We'll give you the eight. That will include the two alternates. Mary Lou Retton, Julianne McNamara, Michelle Dusser, Pam Bilek, Lucy Wiener, Tracee Talavera, Maria Roethlisberger, Kathy Johnson, Now, the last four there have to compete again against Canada in July to see whether they'll be 5, 6, or 7. And Mary Lou Retton, who finished first, and the little jalapeno pepper who explodes like a
exactly.
bunch of Roman candles. I think she runs as fast as Carl Lewis and smiles like an angel. You know? That's a pretty good combination if you're going to be a lady gymnast, isn't it?
I believe so. Like Don Peters said, she is going to surprise a lot of people at the Olympics.
All right, the last one we have not seen in action, Lucy Wiener. And here she is in the floor exercises earlier this evening.
Do you realize in 1983 she was 21st in the all-around at the championships of the USA, and look where she's come. Oh, right into a double back there. Lucy has very nice dance movements. Everything is stretched. Looks like she's taken a great deal of dance classes, or at least practiced hard in the gym on her dance. A tribute to Mary Wright, choreographer of her floor exercise routine. Second tumbling whip over to a full twist. The routine is exceptionally clean on the tumbling, nice and high. Good continuity, she flows, good expression and dance. Lucy has the suppleness in her upper body that some of the younger gymnasts do not have. Many turns on her hands, showing balance. And her last tumbling run will be a double back. Right to the edge, needs as much run as possible to build the speed to pull these two double backs right up in the air. Great finale.
So there you have seen the entire new United States Women's Olympic Gymnastic team. There's Diana Durham, the sad story here tonight with the bad ankle. She did not make the team, but the rest of them did, and they're on their way to Los Angeles. Well, Kathy, thank you very much. We all knew we were going to have the strongest team, but it's a very interesting team, too, isn't it?
It is a great team. Like Don Peters said, it is the best team that we have ever had at an Olympics.
I think that's true about the men, too, Kirk Thomas, isn't it?
Equally as exciting for tomorrow, and I'm excited because the battle between Mitch Gaylord and Peter Vidmar, not only making the team, but 1 and 2, and then Bart Conner obviously trying to get in there, and then there's a couple spots open. It could be really tough, so it's going to be exciting.
All right, Kurt, we're looking forward to working with you and Gordon Thomas here tomorrow for those optionals for the men, and it is a very close, Gordon Maddox, rather, and it is a very competitive and strong team, and I think the people are going to enjoy it very much. We'll be back at 1:30 here tomorrow afternoon at the Coliseum here, and it is a banner year for gymnasts in the United States.
I think for the most part, the boycott is going to affect us, but it's not going to affect us negatively. I